Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and I'm here to give my initial first impressions of Mass Effect Andromeda. Several people have been asking me what do I think of the game as a whole for my first few hours playing, and I figured, well, let's make a video. And this is my gameplay from the Let's Play. So if you've watched my Let's Play, the images you are seeing here and plus some of the things, or most or all the things I'm saying, are going to be very familiar. But this is just concatenating all into one video rather than having people to sit down and watch 4 hours of game. Now, this is spoiler free until the very end. You see what one of the aliens looks and sounds like, and that's only like 3 hours into the game or so. So that's nothing that bad. So other than that, completely spoiler free. I'm not going to give away details of the story and such. Now, I'm going to give a little preamble here. I'm not picky about graphics in general. I still play the original EverQuest. So I can get what people are saying about the graphics, but it doesn't bother me personally, for the most part. The faces. Well, the faces initially did bother me during the character creation. They're very waxy, very like greasy looking, kind of lumpy. So you really got to work with it. And I don't know, I think I got a little lucky. I still see a few things that I could fix on my rider's face, the female face. So I get what people are saying there. It's kind of weird. And as far as the colors, like the little, you know, trying to get the exact color that you want or match colors is almost ridiculous with the little triangle thing they have going on. They could really improve a lot more with the character creation, face customization, whatever you have to call it. The faces are not really expressive like we saw in Mass Effect. So 1, 2, and 3, especially 2 and 3, I think. I don't know. And the eyes are a little weird. Sometimes they don't look like they're looking directly at the character. I'm not completely sure. Sometimes they don't have the expression that they should have on their face when they're listening to someone talk. I don't know. It's strange. It's little things here and there. And like I said, those things really don't bother me. People are saying these are like Oblivion style or Oblivion era graphics. And yeah, maybe so. But that doesn't bother me. You know. So I really can't speak to it. I can understand people's concerns. I feel it's not as good as the... I can't really speak about one. I played one almost a year ago. I'd say it's definitely not as good as 2 or 3. I mean, if that kind of thing bothers you, if you really, you know, demand good graphics, then you might be disappointed. You know, I don't blame anyone for feeling that way. Definitely not. It's just, you know, I can't really complain about it if it doesn't bother me, but I am hearing what people are saying, the videos out there, the comments. Some people are not happy, and that's not a good thing. But like I said, it doesn't really bother me that much. It's like, I don't know, I made a joke about it, that after being in cryogenic suspension for 600 years, which I'm gathering was never attempted before, something messed with our genetic, with their genetic code, and they're mutated wax people now, you know, so. There are a few glitches in the game. I've heard of glitches. I've seen one glitch, which I'm going to put here. It was pretty hilarious. I mean, it's nothing that I haven't seen in games before, so they're going to want to fix that. The thing to remember is that this is a new engine they're working with, so they have to iron out the glitches with their use of the engine here. So I can kind of see how that would happen. I think they didn't want to delay the game more. Maybe the game should have been delayed another month or two to iron these out. Hopefully it won't get too bothersome. Like I'm saying, this is my review of the first mission and a little past, you know, on to when we start, when we, you know, get to where we're supposed to go and we start meeting the alien races and figuring out what's going on as far as, you know, the initial plan of whatever. I haven't gotten that far. So, other than that, the graphics are really crisp. They look excellent as far as, you know, structures, ground, rocks. You know, I spent some time on that planet that we're supposed to be, you know, trying to live on somehow. So, I'd say other than the faces, the graphics are really good. Now, as far as the gameplay, I made some notes for me here. Me personally, running to cover is not the same. It kind of works, but not really. I don't know. You'd have to play it to see. I really got used to, with Mass Effect 2 and 3, running to cover. Run up, hit the cover, and then you're in cover. You don't have that feeling with this one. At least, not so far. So there's that. Lack of a pause feature bothers me. I'm constantly pausing, issuing commands and stuff, and that's the other thing. We cannot issue commands or switch weapons of your teammate, which stinks. Why would they not have that in the game? I do not understand that. And that there's actually power combos used in the game. I guess you can use your own powers to make combos. Or if you see, you know, like if you see one character pull something, you can, you know, you can do warp. Like, oh, they pulled that character. Warp, quick, you know? Something like that. Again, would work better with pause. Like, oh, okay. And then pause and choose your thing because you don't have, you know, a lot of time to use that combo. Once the pull duration is over, then you can't use your combo, obviously. I love the new jump jetpack feature. Very well done. I love the sound, the way it works, and there's some rocks and ledges they have you jump over, you know, on the initial planet where you end up. Habitat 7, and a lot of fun. I like that, traversing like that. Evade is cool. You can evade back, forward, left, right. I can't speak of inventory or profiles because in the trial version, they were not, it was not available. You try to go into it, not available. So I know there are things in inventory. They actually, which is actually very cool that they have an inventory now. There are a lot of objects that you don't know what the hell they are. It's just to sell to a vendor. I found some leather wrappings or something like that, which is pretty self-explanatory, but I found something else, like, I don't know, neutrino emitter or something like that? I don't even know. I don't even remember. I don't know what it is. It would be cool if there was a description of what the thing is, just for flavor, but all it says is that this is an object to be sold to vendors, blah, blah, blah. In fact, I'm pretty sure that's all it says. The negative is 3 hours until I could save. I had to get through the entire mission, get up onto the Nexus, and even then had to go through the Nexus a little bit until I talked to some people, and then I was able to manually save. Again, I'm not sure if that's because I'm playing the trial, or if it's just, it was telling me because I was in a priority mission, I could not save. So I guess during side missions, we can save. Priority missions are very important. I'd want to save even more during a priority mission. One power to start, which I didn't like. All I could do is shoot things and use pull, because I'm bionic. So shoot, 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 pull, shoot, 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 pull. Again, can't use squad powers. They use their powers whenever they feel like it, as part of their AI. So, okay, it was that pulled me. I don't know. That made it didn't pull me out of the combat. It made the combat less interesting to me, less tactical. You could tell your squad mates. Yeah, going back to that, you can tell your squad mates where to go. If you know, tell them to go and that's where an enemy is, they will attack that enemy. Otherwise, they'll go and they'll, you know, hopefully use cover and stuff if you have them go to where cover is. And those are my complaints. Otherwise, the gameplay is great. I've only seen pull. I've seen Liam use a grenade. Pretty cool. The way the enemies fly around when you use pull and grenade is nice. I like it. And I don't know. I don't have too much to say about it because I don't have anything to complain about. It's interesting levels. I think the levels are well done. I like the environmental hazards. You got toxic sludge or puddles or whatever the hell they are. You have mountains, rocks, you got terrain. That's interesting. I feel caves, alien devices that are all very interesting. Unfortunately, I want to interact with them on a greater level than is actually programmed into the game. The scanning feature is very nice. I do like that. I like scanning things. It's almost like scanning on planets, but it's more interesting because you're scanning things in your environment. You're scanning aliens to try to find out their composition, try to find out more about them. When Sam joins you, forgive me guys, if Sam's an AI or a VI, but he helps you out with certain things, gives you information, and basically after the first 2 hours or so of the game, he's always with you. So, very helpful. He helps analyze things and I guess gives you general advice and such. So, then you get even more information about the things that you've scanned. And they've really gone up with basically Mass Effect 2 and 3. It was like one button did everything. You had to go out to the menu if you wanted to look at your map, journal, codex, what have you. Here they've restored all the button presses. I have more buttons mapped and that I actually use than anything. I mean, your powers are you use a key. I have mission track, inventory, interact, which is the general, open containers and just generally open things, interact in any way with objects. There's map, journal, you have evade, scanner, and then scanner execute, which I call it, is if you want to get more information on something you haven't scanned yet. I put sheath weapon, but I know it's not sheath. It's a holster your weapon. And then you got reload, melee, sprint, jump, and then there's keys for the Nomad, which I, have not encountered yet. So for Nomad, there's break, return from Nomad, I think it's go back up to the ship, and there's headlights. You can turn headlights on and off for your Nomad. Again, these are things that I just set the keys, I haven't seen them yet. You press a key to see your current objective, a mission tracker. The map is very cool. I like the map. It's basically got a fog of war type thing, and it unfolds as you move through. Weapon wheel is good. I'm kind of using that as my pause. Someone recommended that to me, so I'm using it as my pause. You can change your weapons, of course, and add mods and stuff to the weapons. With that, Alt is like your camera swap, recenter, look, which is like V in the Mass Effect 3. Of course, there's squad left member, the squad right, and then squad both. You can direct them both to attack, without having to press each key left and right. Really good. Really, key bindings, excellent. I really, really approve, completely approve of that. Could not approve more. The AI, sometimes good, sometimes bad. Sometimes they just stand there and let you keep shooting them, and they're not even in cover. They're just standing there shooting at you. You know, at least they're shooting at you. I mean, this is only the first 3 hours, so the game is young here. But sometimes the AI is really good. Sometimes they'll run right up to cover right near you and take fire. Oh, those crazy dog things, those armadillo dogs or whatever the hell they are, they're pretty scary. They'll come right up to you. So it keeps you on your toes, you know, and you got foes coming from both sides. It's can be challenging. So people like that. I kind of like it. You know, as long as it hasn't happened too often, I start to get annoyed. And I start to think about, what if I bump down the difficulty level a little bit? But overall, yeah, I feel like I'm playing on normal right now, and I feel like it's fine. I'm starting to get used to the combat. Still some improvements there. I'm not the best with shooter type action. You know, I do the best I can. And at this point, 3 hours in, I feel like the story has finally hooked me. I wasn't really getting into it. Hopefully, it keeps hooking me in more and more. So I feel like things will, you know, as far as the story, I think will be pretty good, at least. The voice acting, here's a little pit that's... it's not really a spoiler, guys. It's an alien that you... It's one of the aliens, the alien races that we all know so well from Mass Effect 1 through 3, who we meet on the Nexus along with other aliens. But his voice, I'm just going to tell you, it's a Krogan. Listen to the voice of this Krogan.
At least the Pathfinder here seems willing to try. We could use a fresh perspective.
I'm sorry, that is just so, so wrong. I mean, can a Krogan sound like that? I guess so. But have we ever heard a Krogan sound like that? No. Not at all. So, I don't know what to make of that. I'm almost thinking it's a mistake. Like, his voice is supposed to have whatever, you know, effect put on it. And the effect was never put on it. I feel like... Either way, it's a mistake. Whether they did it on purpose or you know, accidentally, or something's glitched out and his voice is not as low as it was supposed to be, there's just something wrong about that. I'm sorry.
You'd best go talk to Director Tan. Make sure that doesn't happen. And don't be shy. Come see me when you have a chance.
It's just that. My closing thoughts. A lot of people are going to be very critical of this game because a lot of people love the Mass Effect series. So as far as that's concerned, if you have very high standards for the Mass Effect series, you may not like this game. You may hate it. You may be like, eh, it's not that great, but okay. Me, I'm not really that picky. There are little things that bother me. I'm not gonna lie about that. But overall, I am enjoying the game. I'm not trying not to let these little things bother me. I do think it's worth buying. As a game, like as a video game so far, I'd say it's very good. As a Mass Effect game, I say it's fair to good. So that's the thing. If you want a Mass Effect 1, if you want Mass Effect 2, Mass Effect 3, if you want that experience, and that's really just what you want, you don't want anything else, steer clear of this, possibly. If you're like, yeah, you know, it's going to be similar in some ways, and it's going to be different. This is not Mass Effect 1 through 3. This is, you know, a Mass Effect game, but it's different. And not just saying different characters, different story. The gameplay is different. The graphics are different. Things are different. So you can move on from that if you can. You'll enjoy the game, I think. And as far as anyone new to the Mass Effect series, I think you will enjoy it. If you enjoy third-person shooters with science fiction setting, really interesting characters, aliens, good story, at least initially. This is all my first 3 hours. You know, I could be eating my words with some of this stuff after like 20, 30 hours of play. But anyway, if you enjoy that stuff and you have never tried a Mass Effect game, go ahead, pick it up. I would say buy it. If $60 is not going to break you, buy it. Try it out. Hope you enjoy it. That's why you're hearing negatives, is because these things bother people. These things that I've stated, mostly about the graphics and the changes from the Mass Effect trilogy itself, 1 through 3, those things bother people, and they bother people to such great degree. They're expressing their feelings about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. So that's what that is. But everyone's, there's a lot of different people here. There's different factions, and they're all coming from different places about how they feel and what they're willing to accept out of a Mass Effect game. They have very valid opinions, valid arguments. Me, I am not so picky. I'm a little easier to please. And there's nothing wrong with that either, you know? So it's just where you're coming from, what you're willing to accept, what you will enjoy, what will bother you, blah, blah, blah. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for listening. And I really didn't intend for this to go on so long. Hope to see you guys, you know, in another video, maybe in my Mass Effect Andromeda Let's Play. Well, you'll hear me talk about this stuff anyway. So, thanks for watching. See you another time.